Now, before I go further, I want you to understand something about the times in which we live. Before modern times, there were three things that were the most important thing to think about, things to think about in society. The first thing that was really important was God. Not just in Islam, Christianity, Judaism, Hinduism, whatever, God was very important in every society. Okay? The second thing that was really important was the afterlife. So in every, even if they're mushrikun, they had some concept, I'm going to come back as whatever, a tree, a bird, whatever. But it was very important to them to believe that, and to remind themselves of that, to remember God, and to remember the afterlife. And there was a third thing that was really, really important. I want you to remember these three things. There was God, there was the afterlife, and the third thing was the human soul. Okay, the soul of the human was very important. Spirituality was very important. This is true in Japanese culture, in Chinese culture, in Indonesian culture, in pagan religions, and in Islam too, right? Because those are deviations of Islam. Over time, Allah gave Islam to everyone, and over time they deviated. But this idea of spirituality and the soul is virtually in every religion. Now we come to modern times. And in modern times there was a war against religion, right? There was a war against religion. So yes, people believe in God, but God became not as important. Something else became more important. As opposed to God, the universe. Study the universe. Study matter. God is there, is not there, who knows? But the universe is right here. Let's study matter. Let's study physics, chemistry, biology, sciences. Let's study this stuff because it's right here. Right? So there was a shift from the study of the divine to the study of the material universe. That was the first shift. And there was another shift. There was a shift. Instead of worrying about the next life, I don't know if it's going to come or not, which life should we worry about then? This, all of our studies, all of our research, all of our endeavors, engrossed in making this life better and better and better. There used to be talk about making your next life better, right? People used to talk about that at lunch. But now what are we talking about making which life better? This life. There was a shift. There was a shift in thought. Then the third shift, the third shift is what this surah is about. The emphasis used to be on the soul. It changed to an emphasis on the body. Because the human being is made up of two things, right? The body and the soul. Well, the soul, I don't know what's there, if it's there or not. How can we this scientifically calculate it? It can't be seen. What I do see is the body. So when we study the human being before this postmodern society, we study the soul. But after, what do we study? The body, psychology, sociology, you know, even in medicine, etc., etc. The human being has been dissected in 100 different ways, all from the perspective of body. But the human being isn't just a body, is he? There's a body to us and there's also a soul. And what made us the best possible creation? Was it just the soil that Allah created? That Allah told him, angels make sajda to this piece of soil? Or Allah said, وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ I blow into it my ruh, then you fall into sajda. What gave it the honor? The ruh. So that which gave the human being honor is no longer steady, no longer a concern. And that which makes him no different than another animal is steady and concern. Our concern goes to it. Now you will understand perfectly natural comes along another intellectual by the name of Darwin and says we are nothing more than evolved animals. This body is just a more sophisticated version of a monkey. That's all it is. There's a donkey and then the more evolved thing is a horse, right? So all we are more, a better design, monkey 2.0, right? That's all we are. Now if that's all we are, think about an animal. What are the things that an animal wants? It wants to feed its stomach, it wants to fulfill its lust, it wants to protect itself, right? It wants to be the leader of the tribe, the herd, you know, there's a clash between two lions, right? It has herd mentality, preservation of the self. Darwin says, hey, we want all these things. And now all the human being is just a sophisticated animal, nothing more. Nothing more. And do animals have morality? Do animals have right and wrong? Do animals have a sense of justice? No, these things are not in animals. So they're not really in us too. It's just, we're just a higher, you know, more advanced creature. But the thing that gave us honor is removed. The thing that gave us morality is removed. Which is why when you go to a philosophy class in college, your professor will tell you morality is relative. It depends. There's no such thing as absolute morality. This is all man-made stuff. There's no, you know, even religions. Religions are studied as heritages. The reason I mention all of this to you, in the human beings studying, and the way we study human beings today is more sophisticated than we've ever studied it. We know more about the human brain. We know more about human behavior. We know more about the human, you know, all these systems, the digestive, the cardiovascular, all this stuff. We know more about this today than ever before. And interestingly enough, we are more ignorant about what we really are than ever before. At the same time, we reach that oxymoron stage. And you know what's interesting? Allah says in the Quran, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهِ. Don't become like those who forgot Allah. Remember that the concern used to be God. What did the concern become as opposed to God? The universe? As opposed to the next life? What? This life? As opposed to the soul? What? Body. What do these three things have in common? They're all in the unseen. So from the unseen, the focus went from the unseen to the seen. So you forgot Allah. What was the consequence? فَأَنْسَاهُ أَنْفُسَهُ. You forgot Allah, Allah made them forget their own selves. Don't become like those who forgot Allah, because Allah made them forget their own selves. They forgot that Allah had honored them. They forgot that they have a ruh inside of them. All they know, they look at themselves, all they see is what? A body. They don't see a soul. They forgot themselves. SubhanAllah. It's such a profound reality in the Quran. Now you will understand this ayah that we're about to study.